marriage between these two. You may be seated if you want. With that, I'd also like to just open in prayer and share a few words from the scripture. Lord Jesus, we love you. And Lord, you're everything to me. You're everything to us here. Lord, I thank you for this day. I thank you, Lord, for the provision of marriage between a man and a woman. Thank you, Lord, that you designed such an intimate relationship, Lord, that is put together by heaven for us to share together our strengths and our weaknesses. Lord, that we can complement one another, Lord, where the other is perhaps not as strong. Lord, I pray today that, Lord, you would look down upon this moment, that we would feel your eyes upon us, that we would feel and sense your presence, your grace, your mercy, God, and your divine strength, your help and your grace. Lord, I ask your blessing upon it. Joe and Andrea, Lord, and upon every single person that's here witnessing this marriage today. Lord, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. One of the things I like to do in a wedding ceremony is share a little bit from God's Word that proves that marriage is God's design. It's not man's idea. I don't know that Adam would have ever had as good of an idea as to create a helpmeet that was so much like him, but yet so different from him. It would be such a compliment and helps to him in his life here on this earth. Even with God's presence in his life, there was something more that the Lord said he needed. That comes from Genesis chapter 2, beginning in verse 18, where the scripture says, "And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him help me for him. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." You know what's interesting to me, Joe, is when God made us, he made man from a pile of dirt. He gathered up and mixed a little bit of this and that in it, and maybe a little sugar and spice, I don't know, and he breathed on it. He gave life to dirt. You know what's interesting is when you and I pass away, we go back to the very thing that the Creator is from. But with the woman, it's interesting because he said, I'm not going to go back to the same place that I'm in. I'm going to go to a man. I'm going to make there's going to be an intimacy here because she's going to be formed from him. Not from a piece of bone out of the skull of the neck. Not a bone from the foot, but rather from a rib. You know, what's interesting about the rib is it guards the heart. It guards the vital organs of the body. And it's not from the head or from the foot, but it's from the side. And that is what I believe is a beautiful picture of the woman's role and place in man's life. Is that she's not to be the head nor the tail, but she's rather to be at his side. A support, a guard of the heart, a guard of the vital organs. She's an intricate, very close to the very heart of the man. It says in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, Paul says this to the church, and I think this is good for us to recognize our marriage. He says, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries, in all knowledge, and if I have the faith that can move mountains, but I have not love, I'm nothing. And if I give all that I possess to the poor and surrender my body to flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. But then he defines what love is. He says, love is patient, and love is kind, does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, it always perseveres. Love never fails. There's something about this thing of love that comes from God that is supernatural, I believe, in its essence. It has the ability to overcome obstacles. It has the ability to see hope in a hopeless situation. It has the ability to believe again for the future, to believe again for tomorrow. Maybe even when there's not a whole lot of evidence or proof for that, it believes. It chooses. It perseveres. Love never fails. In Ephesians chapter 5, we see the parallel between a husband and a wife a lot like the parallel, which comes from the relationship that Christ has with the church. There's the same connection. There's the same role, if you will. It says in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 24, now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. So maybe we do that. But then it goes on, and it gives a greater call to men. It gives a greater call. So many times we bank on that verse 24, but listen to verse 25 and 26. It says, and husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church, listen, and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by washing with water through the word. So the wife's role is to submit honor to the husband. The husband is to love his wife, even to the point of death, to serve her and cover her, protect her. And that's what the scriptures have to say about marriage. Today, Joe, I have a question for you. Joe, will you have Andrea to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health and forsaking all others? Will you be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Right. Andrea, I have a question for you. Will you have Joe to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him and comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and health, and forsaking all others, will you be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Joe, will you turn and face Andrew? Will you take her by the hand? And will you say these words to her after me? I, Joe, take you, Andrea, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, thereto I pledge you my life. Andrea, will you say these words to Joe after me? I, Andrea, take you, Joe, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge my life. So today, do you have a ring that you would like to present to Andrea as a symbol of your commitment to her? Joe, could just hold that ring for just a second. I love that we have something like a ring ceremony for a couple of reasons. A ring is a circle. And in a circle, to make a circle, there's got to be a complete loop, which to me is a lot like a relationship. In a relationship, you've got giving and you've got receiving. There's a complete circle. And so in any relationship, you know what? If the giving keeps going but the receiving stops, guess what? You don't have a circle, you've got a C-clamp. The C-clamp, all it does is create pressure. But in a circle, in a complete circle, you've got giving and you've got receiving, which is a picture of a healthy relationship. Constantly giving, constantly receiving. When either one of those stop, the relationship begins to struggle. Not only is the ring that we use as a symbol of your commitment today a circle, but it's also a very precious metal. It's not made of something that will corrode, that will rust, that will rot, that will fade away, but it's made of a precious metal like gold or silver or platinum. And so it stands the test of time and lasts. And that's exactly what today's marriage with this wedding is intended to be all about. A lasting relationship of giving and receiving. Joe, will you place that ring upon her ring finger on her left hand? Holding that hand, will you repeat these words to her after me? Andrea, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
In
the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And you give a ring to me. Would you like to give to Joe as a symbol of your commitment to me? Place that ring on his ring finger on his left hand. And will you say these words to Joe after me? Joe, I give you this ring.
Joe, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow. Of all that I am, and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
About why, and I've never been so sure of.
When he created you, I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true.
Thank you.
It's my honor today to be a part of this ceremony. It's a precious moment, not one that we have to fill up and hurry with. You can enjoy it. I enjoy getting to know you. I enjoy your heart. Appreciate your jubilant, moody nature. Your love for God. I know I probably never spoke with you. It's been interesting to see just what the Lord's done in your life, and I know what the Lord will continue to do in your life as we continue on. And it's been a real honor to get to know you, my friend. I consider you to be a friend. Andrea, I could say a lot. Probably not without tears. But I remember when you first came to this church. I remember noticing you sitting over in this area. I mean, the Lord has done such a work in your heart. I think it's phenomenal. The tenderness. It's not that any of us say, we got this thing of following Christ all figured out and perfected. That's not necessarily the aim, but the aim is the heart tender to the nudge, and sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit. Do we respond in the way that God wants us to respond? Do we allow Him to lead us and speak to us, and at times even correct us when we do? And I've seen that in you. I've seen such a tenderness towards the Holy Spirit, towards the Lord in your life, and I'm just overjoyed. You are one of the people in my heart and my mind that I look at and say, that's a person that Christ has touched their life and changed that person. And I see that. I see that happening. And that right there is the greatest joy that a minister could ever hope for, is when the Word of God and the Spirit of God finds a place to rest in someone's life and to bring about that kind of fruit. And it's just my joy today to be a part of the ceremony. I believe that this is the beginning of a long life together. And that as long as you honor the Lord, He will honor you. And as long as you keep God first in your marriage, He will be present there through thick and through thin, through good and through bad. And He will be with you to help you. It's been my honor to do this today. So for as much as Joe and Andrew have consented together in holy marriage, and have witnessed the same before God in this congregation, and have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And those whom God hath joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen?
Amen.
Joe, you may now kiss the bride. And now I would like to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Joe Golob. Will you give them a hand?
Let me speak, God. I believe it's true. Because I can see His love. When I look at you, if He must have a plan for this crazy life, cause He brought you here and placed you by my side. And I have never been so sure of anything before. Thank you.
beautiful party. Amen?
Amen.
On behalf of Joe and Andrea, I'd like to first off thank you for being here, all of you, to witness the giving and exchanging of vows. That is so important. And thank you for being present for that. Also want to give everyone here a quick reminder of the reception that will follow the wedding party taking photos here in the sanctuary. It will be at the waterfront at Riverwalk on the fourth floor, and everyone is welcome. The wedding party will also be in the reception for your area here to greet every single one of you on your way out. And so thank you for being with us this morning or this afternoon. God bless you.